गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, माई नेम इज चित्रा गोस्वामी एंड आई एम वर्किंग एज एन इंडक्टी इवेल्युएटर इन FEA एंड दिस वीडियो इज फॉर द समरी ऑफ लेसन नंबर 51 एंड द नेम ऑफ द लेसन इज डू यू हैव. द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस पार्ट ऑफ द लेसन इज स्टूडेंट्स विल लर्न हाउ टू फॉर्मुलेट द क्वेश्चन यूजिंग डू यू हैव इन डिफरेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट. So the lesson starts by asking the students to log in into their Duolingo accounts and they are going to practice. Then the facilitator is going to ask the students to update any new vocabulary that they have learned from Duolingo on the Duolingo chart. And facilitator is going to encourage the students that they use this vocabulary in the classroom also. The next step starts by asking the students to imagine an imaginary scenario. And the scenario is like, just imagine that you are at your friend's house and you need a pen. Now you're going to ask your friend that, do you have a pen that I can borrow? And your friend is going to quickly reach out to their bag or to his table and he is going to lend you a pen. The simple question, do you have, is a very handy way to politely ask anybody if they have something that we need. You're going to tell your students that today we are going to explore how to use do you have in different contexts or to ask about things that others might possess. So you're going to begin the class by asking a very simple question. And the question is, have you ever used the phrase do you have when asking for something? After taking responses for the question, you're going to ask the students to watch the AV1 of the lesson. While the students are watching the AV, it is optional that they can also read aloud the sentences given in the part 2 of the AV. After the students are done watching the AV, you're going to write on the board, do you have? Now you're going to ask all the students the same question, do you have a pencil? And the students are going to answer. Now they're going to have a pencil and they're going to answer, yes, I have a pencil. Or they might not have a pencil and they will say, no, I don't have a pencil. So if they have a pencil, you're going to write, yes, I have a pencil on the whiteboard. Now you're going to ask another question, do you have an airplane? Now they obviously will not have an airplane and they will say, no, I don't have an airplane. And you're going to write the same response on the whiteboard. Students are going to refer to these sentences for the next activity. The next step is a stand up and sit down activity based on the question, do you have? We are going to ask the students a series of questions that is given in the FRB. If the answer is yes for the students, they are going to stand up, and if the answer is no for them, they are going to sit down. Let's take an example. So if the question is, do you have a pen? So the students that have a pen will stand up and the students that do not have a pen will sit down. After that, you are going to call on two or three students to share their answer in full sentences. For the students who had the pen, they are going to share, yes, I have a pen. And for the students that did not have a pen are going to share that, no, I do not have a pen. Next step is a game and the name of the game is hide the stone. So before starting the game, you are going to explain the rules of the game. First, you are going to choose a student who is going to become a guesser. The guesser will either leave the classroom or will close their eyes. While the guesser has closed their eyes or has left the classroom, you are going to hand one small stone to one of the students in the classroom. But the other students will also make a fist, acting like they also have the stone in their hand. So after that, the guesser will come inside the classroom or they will open their eyes. And now they have three chances to guess which student has the stone. So they are going to ask the same question with every student. Do you have the stone? So if the student has the stone, they will say, yes, I have the stone. And if the student does not have the stone, they're going to say, no, I don't have the stone. After that, you're going to choose a new guesser and you can repeat the activity as the time allows. The next step is discussion practice. So the students are going to practice English with their partner. You're going to give the students 10 minutes to speak in English with their partner. So they can ask some questions like, what is in their bag or things they have in their home or what family members they have and so on. The facilitator can also give them a challenge for using my and your in the sentences at least twice. Next is the energizer and the name of the energizer is Wah. For this energizer, the students are going to stand in a circle and each student will clasp their hands together. You can either explain the rules or give a demonstration for the rules. The first person is going to say Wah while raising their hands above their head like the formation of a tree. The students on the left and right side of the first person are going to do a cutting motion towards them while saying va without touching the first person. First person again is going to say va, is going to swing down in a bent motion and is going to point towards another student, and it should be clear who they are pointing to. So the game can continue in a rhythmic motion, and whoever breaks the rhythm will be considered out from the game. The game will go on until only two people remain, and they both will be considered the winner. Second part of the lesson is talking to parents or guardians, part 1, thank you cards. And the objective of this part of the lesson is students will recognize why it is important for them to talk to their parents or guardians, and students are going to write thank you cards for their parents by writing something specific in the card that they appreciate about their parents or guardians. The lesson will start by a TPS activity, and the question for the TPS are: how often do you talk to your parents or guardians every week, and how long do these conversations last? Second question is, what kinds of things do you talk to your parents or guardians about? And the third question is, are there any topics that you feel uncomfortable while discussing with your parents and guardians, and what are those topics? After the TPS activity is done, you are going to conduct a whole class discussion with the question, why might it be helpful to talk to your parents or guardians about your choices, like your career paths? And the second question is, what are the challenges of having these conversations? Next step, you are going to start by explaining that whether or not you fight with your parents or guardians, or they have an argument with you, they want you to succeed in your life. To build a positive relationship with them, it is going to help you feel very supported in your life. We are going to start small by making some thank you cards for our parents and guardians. Students are going to fill the chart that is given in the part A of their SAB. After that, the students are going to share at least one thing that they have written in the chart. The students can also share additional things that they want to add in the chart. After that, it is time to make the thank you cards for their parents. The students can use the art supplies to make the cards. They can make it as creative as they would like them to be. Write the card, they are going to write at least one reason why they appreciate their parents. As a homework, you are going to ask the students to present the card aloud to their parents and tell them the reason why they are thankful. The students will be given extra 2 nights to complete this activity. They are going to encourage all the students to complete the activity. After this, you are going to wrap up the session by acknowledging the students of what they did well in the class, and they are going to conduct the pledge. Thank you so much.